How if you still believe in him though you have not seen him?
The deeper the valley, You will never, never God, his father, and his mother, and his beloved too. And he not his children, his brothers and sisters, yeah, and his own self. He cannot be my disciple. And whosoever does not bear his cross and come after me, he cannot be my disciple. If you're not homeless as doves, you will never, never, never make it. Ooh. And if you're not wise as a serpent, you will never, never, never make it. Ooh. Don't worry about the money. It's just silver or gold. You don't even have to have two coats. I will provide for you. A servant cannot be greater than his master. So just try to be like me. If they called me Beelzebub, you can expect trouble too. But whosoever receives you, they receive me too. Listen. If you give your life for me, you will find your life again. If you're not homeless as doves, you will never, never, never make it. Ooh. And if you're not wise as a don't worry about the money, it's just silver or gold. Don't even have to have two coats, I will provide for you. Don't worry about the money. It's just silver or gold. You don't even have to have two coats. I will provide for you. And a servant cannot be greater than his master. So just try to be like me. If they called me Beelzebub, you can expect trouble too. But whosoever receives you, they receive me too. And if you give your life for me, you will find your life again. If you're not homeless as doves, you will never, never, never make it. Ooh. And if you're not wise as a serpent, for this is the secret of all wisdom, you will never, never make it.
Your presence, I need to know your power. Fill me now with more of you. I need to see your glory. I want to know your will. So would you please come and fill this place? Oh, just the clay. So mold me and shape me into what you want me to be, and I'll be changed from glory into glory.
Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. Father, thanks for this great opportunity. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. This morning, we are looking at talking about holding back. I brought a third member here. A vision? Not a problem. This one does not even want to join. You just come and you don't want to be obedient. But look at the old one, it's almost finished. And he's still saying that he's going to come full time. Give his all to God. What type of candle is this? Candle cycle. Okay, holding back. Proverbs 21. Hey, brother, something wrong with it. All day long, he is craving while the righteous gives and does not hold back. The first thing you must know about holding back is that the righteous person does not hold back. Do you see? A righteous person does not hold back. Amen. So, How many are righteous? So if you are righteous, you must decide to not hold back from today. Go all the way. There's a song that I want us to learn. It's called All the Way. I'm going all the way, no matter what. Do you know how to sing it? Why not?
All the way. I'm going all the way, no matter what tomorrow brings. All the way. I'm going all the way, so don't even try to turn me around. Oh yes, I'm going all the way. I've got to go all the way. Oh yes, I'm going all the way. I've got to go all the way. All the way. I'm going all the way, no matter what tomorrow brings. All the way. I'm going all the way, so don't even try to turn me around. Oh yes, I'm going all the way. I've got to go all the way.
Wow. Number two, there is nothing to lose when you do not hold back. Job chapter 16, verse 6. If I speak, my pain is not lessened. If I speak, my pain, the pains of life, are not lessened. And if I hold back, what has left me? Or what? If I hold back, do you see? What has left me? So if I speak, my pain is not lessened. In other words, I have nothing to lose by speaking. Amen. Because when you speak and you do the work of God and you minister the will of God, the pains of this life and the issues that we will all go through are all going to be the same. All my classmates, my mates, my friends from school, we have all suffered in this life since we came. We have all experienced similar struggles in this world. It's true. I have a lot of mates who are my classmates. We are still friends. Our lives are similar in terms of the pains of life, the issues, the different things that we've gone through. Do you see? Since we left school. Are you with me? If I hold back, what has left me? So if I speak, my pain is not less. Preaching the word of God. You see, when I was in school, being serious in the school, serious in God, did not make me not do well in medical school. I did well. And there are others who do all sorts of things whilst in school. Tennis competitions, Miss Ghana, Miss Malaika, huh? The current Miss Ghana is in fourth year. When did she become Miss Ghana? Was she in medical school? She was a medical student. Yeah. And she was third in Miss World. Miss what? Legon. Was a medical student. And she's a Miss Legon, and she's in school. Yeah, it's fantastic. So she has giving herself to go for that beauty pageant, go and dress, do this. So many meetings they go for to be a Miss whatever, training, coaching, and everything. And they miss lectures. Do you see? For 2 weeks or a month. And then they become Miss Ghana. And then they also qualify from the medical school. Are you listening to me? And what has left you when you speak? Nothing. So that is why I constantly challenge the people who are hiding themselves and holding back and saying, oh, because I'm medical school, and because of that, one or two things, you know, in medical school, we have a lot of lectures, a lot of examinations, a lot of things that we are doing. Huh? We are very busy, more than other students. And because of that, Bishop, after school, God is, he will never leave us. After school, we will work for God all day long. This is all our promise to God. Hey. But what God is telling us is that if I speak, my pain is not lessened. If I hold back, what has left me? In other words, what is the point in holding back? What is the advantage in holding back? There's no advantage. You think you are busy now. You will be more busy after school. Take it from me. And you will wish you can go back to school. Trust me. Look at Tilly. She used to be here. She's working. She cannot come. She wishes she was here. She said she met me as a bishop. I cannot believe that I'm not here. Because she's working. The camp is going on. Yeah. You don't know that you are enjoying. Yeah. So thank God. Ministry is not just coming for camps. The camp is for a reason. Hey. Yeah. There must be a reason. There must be. Are you listening to me? If I hold back my pain and the pains of my life and of this life are not going to be any less. Amen? So give yourself and your life to Jesus. Don't hold back any love. Otherwise, God is going to give you a beloved who will hold back. So that, or a husband or a wife who will hold back so that you see what it is. Pepe. To have a holding back person in your life. Are you listening to me? Amen. Number 3. We can feel it when you are holding back. God can feel it. And anybody you are working with or moving with can and does feel it. That you are holding back. Amen. Second Corinthians chapter 6. Don't hold back. Amen. Don't do what? Don't hold back. 2 Corinthians chapter 6. If we read it in the American Bible, it would be much easier to understand. Amen. Verse 12. You are not restrained. Oh, in verse 11. Our mouth has spoken freely to you. Or the NIV. We have spoken freely to you, Corinthians, and opened wide our hearts to you. Amen. We are, this one says, you are not restrained by us. But the NIV, which is the anti-supernatural version, makes it quite plain. We are not withholding our affection from you, but you are withholding yours from us. Corinthians. You see, you can have a church which is holding back, withholding their affection. Amen. Amen. You can also have a businessman who could support the church, but he's withholding his affection for God. And when it comes to other things, he releases his affection. Are you listening to me? He releases and opens his heart and lets all his affections go. Now, some people's marital problems is this, that the person they love is not loving them freely. You see that you are withholding your affection. And it is a major problem, because there are a lot of people who don't know how to love. Yeah, they don't know how to love. They are just wanting a ring, or they want a child, but they don't know how to love. So they withhold their affection. And it is a very frustrating thing for somebody who has come with all his heart and all his mind, or her mind, his soul. Yeah. And then, not that you've given it to somebody, but it's like, I'm just cool. Hello. Yeah. Hi. How is it? Fine. I've missed you. I've missed you. It's powerful. I love you. Thank you. Do you miss me? Of course, I miss all those I don't see. Those I don't see. As I haven't seen you for some time, I've missed you. Do you love me? But I've told you before. Are you happy that we are together? Of course, I'm always happy. I told you. Wow. Is it amazing? Is it fantastic? Yeah. It's very frustrating. In fact, many people's beloved doses problems and marital problems boil down to this one thing. that one is all out and one is holding back. One is exuberant and one is cool. You love me. My mother too told me that this is what the same thing. You see, that's what's in the head. You see, sometimes there is an evil thought in the head about the person. My mother told me that this is how a man will talk. So I am not surprised that you say that you love me. I say, I have heard. I hear you. Wow. And actually, it is the problem of almost every relationship. Yeah, almost every relationship. Rarely do two people with equal extent of love meet. Yeah, rarely. Are you sad about what I'm saying? You are disturbed. Maybe different levels of expression of the love. Like, one will come. Oh, hello! And you also can say, hello! Hello. It's like, you move your shoulder. Yeah. And one is just coming with a shoulder. Wow. Is it not amazing? Is it not fantastic? Yeah. This is what God is experiencing. God is really, really suffering from a broken heart. He's come with like all out to die for you, and you, it's like evening, one evening you come and it's like God is taking too much time. Huh? And no, I wouldn't understand why you wouldn't want to give him your everything, you know, when he loves you so much. He loves you so much that he gave his only begotten son. So when people get married, they find out that, oh, I saw moi. You married me because you just wanted to have a ring. And you married me because you wanted to have a name. And you married me because you wanted to change your name from Miss to Mrs. And you married me because you wanted to have a child. And so you were very serious about having the children. 1, 2, 3, plus 2, 5. The twins at the end became 5. After that, you switch off. Life is over. And you return back to your shell. And you live in a beastly way. Most relationships have one is like this, one is like this, like this, like that. Most. Like that. A-M-O-B-O. You will feel sorry for the one who is come with all his. You know what I mean? And then another one is just cool like that. Are you happy? I say, your face, you don't. That is how it is. We are chatting and you are not saying anything. But it's not always that I feel like saying. It's not always that I have to speak. Is it always that I have to speak? to show that I love. Sometimes there are quiet moments where we don't speak much. Meanwhile, the quiet moment is all the time. Sometimes there are quiet moments. Wow. Sometimes a husband will do so many things. A Christian husband. Or the Christian wife. Maybe the good Christian wife, she will do everything that she knows. Do this. We have about 9 duties of the wife. She will learn all. Oh, yeah. There are, see, every relationship is like this or like this. Depending on which one you got. Some are similar, but some is quite a difference. Yeah. It's almost like Lotto. The wife will learn everything. When she marries you, she realize that the language that you speak is Ghana. Although she is not a Ghana, she will learn how to speak Ghana. Yeah. Or she's Nina from another place. She doesn't speak tree. But she will learn how to speak tree. Wow. Then your foods that you eat, she will learn them for you. Although originally she doesn't eat such food, and she's even afraid of it. When she's cooking it, she will learn it. Yes. One day I met a lady from the Caribbean. She married a Ghanaian. She was an expert at making shito. Hey, some of you don't know how to make shito. You don't know how to make it. You don't know much, including shito. You don't know how to make it. She learned how to make a lot of food. Ghanaian, okra stew, this stew, that. I mean, everything, she knew it. So there are some wives, they come and they give everything all out. Then your sexual peculiarities. She would adjust herself. Somebody who is very quiet and calm, you see that in the room, there is an acrobat. There is acrobatics. And then you will see that there is gymnastics. Yes. Oh, Nale quiet, she challenged. Because of love. All out. Hey. Gymnastics, acrobatics, and what? Aerobics. Wow. Then you, a husband, will hold back your money. Money that you have. You see that it's like money becomes a discussion. Money. Because you are holding back. You've gone to work. Your salary was 250. And we cannot see the 250 in the house. Huh? Yes. Or you have held it for your sister's children and your cousins and your relatives. Yeah. Ashantis have relatives. And other, not only Ashantis, it depends on your family. So that you are holding back what she has made okra stew for, which she doesn't eat. Aerobics, which she has never been to the gym before. And she's not a dancing star. She was a singing star. Because of you, she has opened her heart. And 250, instead of bringing it for her to be happy in the house, that all that I have is 250. That we are all going to enjoy it. What I can pay is all this. But when the person comes, you say, so where is the money? No man said, I've told you, I'll get some money. I'm coming. Light off. How to put electricity? It become a meeting. A meeting. School fees is a meeting. To extract, when they are taking money from you, it's like your tooth is being removed. Meanwhile, she has learned all the things. The time that he comes home at work, from his work, is coming around midnight. Meanwhile, that's the time that your sleep has also come deeply. You have learned how to rise and be moving around. Oh, what a wife. You have not held back. By his 250, he has held it. Any brother here, if you marry and there is meetings in your house about money, you are a bad husband. I'm telling you that. You write it down for the future. Write it. You are a bad husband. Some of you have seen it already in your house. Don't bring that thing to the house of God. Money is for the women. They need to be happy. What type of man are you? Sisters, be quiet. Don't clap too much. You know, just take your time. You are a bad husband. Open. You see, I'm not even assuming that you are giving it to somebody. But let us assume that you are even holding back. Bring the 250 so that we all discuss how to connect water and connect light to the house. Are you getting what I'm saying? How to buy food. It shouldn't be a meeting. Somebody has opened their heart and somebody has held back. Yeah. We also have on the other side, see that the brother, or even this man who is there, he will be sitting there, he doesn't speak, he doesn't communicate. Yes, it's always thinking in the house. Nobody for the wife to talk to, although she has opened her heart to provide LLI, which is lower level interactions. Now, when it comes to the upper level interaction, you are always thinking. You see, I'm training you as a good Christian. When you come with your unimproved version, all beautiful girls here smell, but they have improved by bathing. What about in chong? Oh. Keep thyself holy. Look at what you are trying to give to the Lord of your life. Are you listening to me? So, Christian, a good Christian of the relationships, and you have it in relationships, you see that one will belly his heart. Do you understand? Belly. It's opening the heart to visit you. You'll be visiting. But you, dear Charlie, you will never open your spirit to visit. You will never come. Or the person will belly his heart to be calling you and texting you. And then you will not respond now, then you send a response. I see. One later, I see. After you have received text like diarrhea, plenty. I miss you. I'm going here. I'm doing this. We are here. We are doing this. And then we'll send around. I see. I hear you. Okay. Thanks. TX. Thanks. Oh, amen. You send a text. Amen. Amen. Great. Meanwhile, there are only two of you in the relationship. Two. Many of my texts, the answers are very short because I have a lot of texts. But I can also decide I will not even reply. Yeah. But all my answers are short. But we are not only two. It's not only me and you. It's me and we are a lot. Yeah. But you are only two. And they have sent a lot of nice messages. The only message you have sent back is, I see. I hear you. I hate you. LOL. 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 You are sending LOL. And Utrecer, you are withholding your love. Don't hold back. Yeah. But that's how it is. Jesus has come giddy running. Giddy. I'll die for you. I'll die. I'll do everything. When he's finished dying for us, then he said, do you love me? He said, I should come Tuesday evening. I should come on Wednesday in the evening. Once a week. Oh, I hear you. Meanwhile, Jesus has brought himself giddy. He's running. He's coming to die. I love you. I love the world. I love you. I'll die for you. And when he finished dying, he gets up and says, do you feel whatever? I say, oh, LOL. Oh, it's powerful. It's powerful that you died. I mean, I didn't ask you to die, but I mean, if you wanted to die, I mean, Charlie, it wasn't my intention for you to die. If you've died, I mean, thanks. I mean, you chose to die. I mean, we should love ourselves, but not to die. Point. You see, the story here, you wonder, or the brother will be an A1 husband, will get up, do this for you, organize this, care for you. You never ask for anything. Everything is organized, done for you, cared for. Wow. When it comes to that, you will cook something. See, that cooking has become an issue to even present arms. Cannot present because you when we were preaching at the camp, you didn't learn how to cook every day. So we will cook, but you don't know anything. An improved version, so hair and so dressing, 000. You cannot cook when you are together in the house. It's two brothers who are there. It's two brothers. You might as well remove those earrings so that we know that we are two boys. When it comes to sexical things, instead of trying to be an aerobics assistant, you say, no, I cannot. What do you take me for? And you say, you think I'm one of those. I'm one of those. What do you take me for? How do you see me? Huh? You think I'm a slave? You think I'm a slave? I'm a sex machine? You think I'm one of those girls you've been watching on those pornography? Nonsense. Those people are professionals. Those people are professionals. They are paid to do what they are doing. What do you take me for? But he has also paid. He has done dowry. He's done engagement. He has done so. He has given you his name. Oh. Always. One loves like this. Another one loves like this. And gradually it breaks the heart of the one who laughs so much. And then he starts to calm down. And then he lowers the, or she lowers it. But she say, I used to make ebonobono for you. Do you know ebonobono? Ebonobono? Is that what they call it? Ebonobono? 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 I used to make ebonobono for you. You didn't appreciate it. I used to do gymnastics for you. You didn't appreciate it. I used to clean all your clothes for you. You didn't appreciate it. I used to do everything. Your friends, I used to talk to them. You didn't appreciate it. I'm also feeling tired now. We are all just be there in the house. And then gradually, so from here, this will come down. Then this one also, what do you do? Okay, I'm coming down. This one says, oh, no, I'm coming down. This one, I'm coming down. Coming down. Then when you meet them, when they are older, I say, it's down. 1-to-1. We are all looking at each other. Hey, Mobo. That's how love gets finished. Yeah. Don't hold back. Give thyself wholly. So Jesus, this is Jesus' problem. He's come to us with power alone. Giddy giddy. Giddy giddy. Do you understand? Giddy giddy. Giddy giddy. Hey, Charlie, we will save the people. Charlie, let's move. Let's go. Holy Spirit, let's go. Power, we shall miracles. They will believe. Let's go. Giddy giddy. Come. People come say, why? Why are you frenzied? Why are you so heated up? Have you eaten today? Have you eaten today? Jesus, have you eaten? Are you feeling hungry? You should have asked me whether to die before you die. I have not intended to die. Yeah. So watch out, because that's how love gets finished. Yeah. As a pastor, there are times I felt silly. Come to try to preach to people about the work of God. Come, giddy, giddy. Charlie, we have to do something. And the people will look at you. Bishop. Bishop. Your father has money. That is why I say all these things. Oh! Then my love will just... And people ask, so, Bishop, why these days you don't have camps with us? Because you may cast your mind back. When I had a camp with you and I opened my heart, what response did I get? No response. And I realized, I've come to the wrong place to love. The last thing I wish for you is a marriage or a relationship where the love is not coming the same way. Charlie, you people must all have long relationships, I'm telling you. Enter the relationship now and watch the thing. Charlie, call now, the person is not able to give you a sense. Charlie, you know something. You know something. You are holding back. And it's because of that, no? I've changed my mind. See you later. Hey. We are not withholding our affection from you, but you are withholding yours from us. 2 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 12. We are not withholding our affection from you, but you are withholding yours from us. Amen. Now, number three. What was number one? Righteousness. Number two is one. Number three is what? We can feel it when you are holding back. Number four. It is a curse to hold back. Curse. Jeremiah chapter 48 and verse number 10. Jeremiah 48, verse number 10. Glory to God. Jeremiah 48, verse number 10. Cursed be the one who does the Lord's work negligently, and cursed be the one who restrains his sword from blood. Jeremiah 48 and verse 10. Curse on him who is lax in doing the Lord's work, and a curse on him who keeps his sword from bloodshed. So who holds back his sword? It's a curse be the one. As we are going to fight, you will not be coming forward with strength. I should go and die. Do you see? It's very dangerous to go to war with people who it's like they've made their mind that, Charlie, me, I'll run. When I hear, no, Charlie, I'm running. When I hear, I say, Jesus, I cannot die a foolish death. I cannot die here. What? I'm going. And that is how, and that's why an army is made up of people who are always being disciplined. Sometimes you wonder, why do they make them parade? Well, what are all these useless marches up and down, stand there at ease, salute, this, slow march, fast march? I mean, why? It's like, get used to being told, being doing what is needed to be done without thinking. But not that when we go and we say, hey, you say, hey, tell me, but you find that never. I'm not a fool. Yeah. So the training, so even you know, when you come to camps, that's why most of the pastors are people who have been to camps. Yeah, all my pastors are, all the pastors come from camps. Because to come and sit here for hours is alone is discipline. It's listening to what is being told, doing what you are told to do, being obedient, being humble. It's part of military training. Do you see? And so you find out that it produces people who, when you tell them, go to Guinea, they just go. And they say it's an honor. Because soldiers are taught to die for what they, and they are made to be happy to die. And they are given a reason to die. Die for your nation. Don't think about it. Just die for your nation. Meanwhile, you are not really dying for your nation. You are dying for a madman's idea, like Hitler or Napoleon. You are dying for an egomaniac who wants to get so much power which he cannot even use or control. Yeah. And you go fighting battles, doing brutal things for nothing. But they make them do it, and they do it happily. Yeah. That is how it is to be a soldier and to be disciplined. And so you it's very, very dangerous. That's why you even find them cursing those who would run away and turn away. Stalin, the commander of the Russian army, the president of Russia, he produced a law. When you turn back, you'll be shot. You'll be shot. Because curse is the man. Because we've all formed a line here. And we are fighting. And if we stay, based on our numbers, we are 200. The guys cannot come. But as I'm fighting, I realize that 160 have run away. And we are very few. Say, hey, Charlie, we are only 40. Oh. The guys say, I mean, Charlie, let's all run. You have spoiled the whole fight. By you holding back or running away when some of us decided to go forward. That's what has happened. You are killing us. So holding back is very destructive. And that is why somebody would place a curse on those who return, those who hold back, those who that we are all going. If we even know that we are 40, we will never venture into certain things. But we ventured thinking that we were more. Yeah. It's the same thing. I would not have married you if I had known that you were going to give me only 40% of a woman's love. And all my life I will be begging. Yeah. Don't hold back. It's dangerous. One day Kenneth Hagin said he was somewhere and then, you know, he wanted to go out preaching and his wife, you could see that his wife was not happy with it. I said, go here, come, go, come, go, come. I said, why? I want a normal husband. You know? So one day he was preaching and he collapsed. And it was like he was having either a heart attack or I don't know what. So his wife and they were all rushed like the scene I was reading in the book. You know, but when she bent over the husband, then a voice told her, a voice said, I can take him where he will never come back. So let him go so that he goes and comes, goes and comes, goes and comes. It's better than go and not come. Yeah. She said it. Kenneth Hagin always talked about that thing that happened. That the Lord told her, I can take him and he will never come back. Rather, it will be better that he goes and comes, goes and comes, goes and comes. Than it's like you go because you are holding him back. You hold him back and he will die in the house. Amen. So there are people, many times we don't realize that holding back is a very terrible thing. Don't hold back. Don't hold back your husband from the ministry. Don't keep him away from doing what God has called him to do. You are a witch. Witchy woman. Come and deceive us with your beauty, then we have married you by mistake. But we couldn't see because you attended two camps. We thought you were a good person. You came with your beauty. Not knowing that you are not correct at all. Oh, married you. Now you are spoiling the church, spoiling the mission, threatening the guy in the house all the time. Because you've seen that the guy is a nice person. He's a very good person. He's not, so strong to terrorize you or punish you. He's just pleasant and easygoing. That is what you are taking advantage of to manifest like a witch, Jezebelic manipulator of husbands and pastors. Cursed be you, Jezebels. Cursed be you, Jezebels. Cursed be you, Jezebel. Manipulators of pastors, manipulators of apostles, manipulators of servants of God, trying to twiddle them around your hand, using your sexual appeal to deny and to control, to give a little and hold back a little, give a little teaser and hold back, to use your powers to control. Cursed be you, Jezebels. Cursed be the manipulators of God's apostles and God's pastors. Cursed be you. You are cursed to wither. You will be replaced. 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 I prophesy your replacement. I declare your replacement has happened. You will be surprised and shocked that you will be replaced and another will stand in your place and another will sit in your chair and another will lie in your bed. More worthy of that position than you. Wicked manipulator. Killer of souls. Killer of churches. Killer of people. The blood is on your head and on your hand as you have redirected a man of God's life away from his God who called him. You are cursed. Yeah. Come and sit here with your beautiful face. It's like, oh, I love the Lord. I love the Lord. It's like, we know what they want. There are some few things when you say them, they will choose you just now. Number one, go for camp. Number two, say amen. Number three, smile. Number four, do this. They will like you just now. These boys, oh. When you get them, oh, then that is it. You start. Yeah. Cursed be you. I'm running. I'm running well. I'm running well. I'm running well. I'm running well. Then you bring your leg out like this. I'm running. Oh, I'm running to my victory. Put your leg in. When I get there, then you bring it out and tell me if she's not a wicked girl. I'm running to my victory. I'm running. I'm running. I'm running. Ah! You. You. I was going there. By now, I've gone there. I've stayed here for 7 years. 7 years I've stayed here struggling with you. Look at where I would have reached. Are you not a wicked girl? Was I not running well before I met you? My whole race has been affected. Your beautiful, shiny, blue, whatever. If I had seen it well. But I was running, I was concentrating on my race. Concentrating on my race. I saw the high calling. I saw the high calling. And I was going. I was going. I was going. I was going. By somebody else. Somebody will take your place. Somebody more worthy will sit there. Yeah. I was running well. Stumbling block shall come. But woe to he. Woe to he who causes even one of my little ones to stumble. To come down. To stumble is to be brought to a stop. And to fall down and to come down less than you would have been before. I was doing well. I was doing well. I was so motivated by the messages and by the camp. I was running. I was good at running forward. I was even good at running sideways. And I was even good at running backwards. I mean, I was so flowing. I was flowing. I was jumping. I was running. I was running. I was running. I could run backwards. Aye! Really? That's what you want to do to me. Because I said I will never divorce. As a good Christian, I've decided I will not divorce. And because of that, you are manipulating, kicking me, eh? Not kicking me. Because 7 years of my ministry has ended here. Because I met you. You use your ties and buttocks to charm me. I was also charmed because I was in need. I was hungry. When I saw it, hey Shabaya, my God, Charlie, come and let me pray for you so that Father, we cancel all such negativities in Jesus' name. Thank you for your blessing and your help, Jesus. Amen. Are holding back your husband. The next one, holding back, comes from looking back. In it, Luke 9, verse 62. Jesus said unto him, no man having put his hand to the plow and looking back is fit for the kingdom of God. Amen. Amen. Who are you looking back to in a relationship? You are thinking of an old boyfriend and an old girlfriend and an old love. Then you become cool towards Mr. Unfortunate who has decided to, Brother Unfortunate who has decided to beloved those you. Is Brother what? Brother Unfortunate, as he's come with all his heart, giddy giddy, he's brought himself. First love, you are his first love. But he is your 17th love. He is your 17th love. And you are remembering number 16, number 14, number 12, number 11, number 10. So your love is restrained. You get it? And Brother Unfortunate has come to belovedos you. Oh. Do you see? So looking back, you realize that you are not flowing in this relationship. You are not happy because you are thinking that other brother, Charlie, he was very gentle. She was very kind. He used to speak softly. She managed harsh. He's always shouting. Difficult. He's raw. Unimproved. But I like the other guy. That guy was funny. You know, he was funny. He was nice to be with. He used to crack jokes and we're always happy. Wow. But this one is, I mean, always scriptures, Leviticus. I mean, he doesn't have anything to say apart from scriptures and other somehow boring. Not that I don't believe in the word. I like the word. Not that it's boring, but it's like I want him to talk about other things too. But it's mostly holiness code, scripture, and other things. Church work and all that. It's not that I'm against the church. I'm not against the church. But it's like everything is about that. And then when he's talking to me, it's always as if he's talking to a sheep. But I'm not a sheep, I'm a beloved. And he's speaking like a shepherd, sharing things and saying, you must do this. Are you working on this? Are you doing this? Are you doing this? And I'm not experiencing love and friendship. It's more shepherdorial belovedosis. It's like he's counseling me always. I'm undergoing constant counseling. I want a normal relationship without too much counseling. Hey. There are no flowers in the relationship. In my old relationship, I was there when I was in the house when I received a DHL. When I opened the DHL, what did I see? I love you. He has sent it from Dansoman to Labadi, DHL. DHL. When I opened the DHL, I thought it was from abroad, but it was just from Labadi here. When I opened, it said, I love you. I showed it to all my friends. And they said, oh, this one there, your beloved is amazing. Supernatural. Supernatural. A1. Wow. But this one, social counseling and advice, he's always giving advice, exhortations. Since we went to the camp and they spoke about exhortations, the exhortation has never ended. Hey, hey. Wow. Or you have married. You are sleeping with your husband. And you are remembering somebody. You are saying that this guy doesn't know anything. Oh. Is it a nice way of thinking? It's like, oh. He's a brother, virgin Atlantic brother. He's an inexperienced brother. I have to train him. I have to teach him. Ooh. And then you have remembered Dirty Daniel. Wow. So looking back makes you hold back. Watch out for those of you who are looking back. Yeah. When you decide you are going into the ministry, don't look back again. When I decide I'm going to the ministry, I say poverty, riches, zero, nothing, I'm going all the way. Yeah. When I started healing Jesus Christ, I said, whether anybody comes or not to the crusade, I will have the crusade. I will have the crusade. Yeah. This one is burning fast because some people's lives go faster. So sometimes by the age of 28, much of your life has gone already. You not take the whole day. The whole time you normally thought it will last the whole day. So by around 4 o'clock, I'll give myself holy. But not knowing you were going to expire at 11 o'clock. Yeah. So you can see it's going so fast. This one took the whole of yesterday. Yeah. This one, in a few hours, is getting finished because his life is shorter. He's been allotted a shorter time. But he doesn't know. Wow. So looking back, now, looking back can make you lose what you have. Holding back can make you lose what you have. That's the next one. You can lose everything. Songs of Solomon chapter 5, verse 1. I have come into my garden, my sister, my bride. I have gathered my myrrh along with my balsam. I have eaten my honey. I have drunk my wine and my milk. Eat, friends. Drink and imbibe deeply, O lovers. I was asleep, but my heart was awake. Songs of Solomon 5, verse 2. A voice, my beloved, was knocking. Open to me, my sister, my darling, my dove, my perfect one. For my head is drenched with dew, my locks with the damp of the night. Verse 3. I have taken off my dress on my robe. How can I dirty them again? My beloved extended his hand through the opening, and my feelings were aroused for him. Hey. Shabaya. Verse 5. I arose to open to my beloved. My hands dripped with myrrh, and my fingers with liquid myrrh on the handles of the bolts. I opened to my beloved, but my beloved had turned away and had gone. My heart went out for him. I searched for him, but I did not find him. I called him, but he did not answer. I sought him. He was gone. He was gone. He was gone. How sad. Look at how the guy came with zeal looking for his beloved. He said, my head is filled with dew. My arms and my hands are filled with myrrh. Hey, minister de pone. My feelings were aroused for him. I arose to open to my beloved. My hands dripped with myrrh. I've taken off. But you see, the thing started by giving excuses. When she said to him, open up. The story keeps shifting from one speaker to the other. When he said, my beloved was knocking. Open to me, my sister, my darling. Then she started giving excuses. I'm already in bed. I've washed my feet. I've bathed already. How can I dirty them again? Excuses, oh. Reluctance. Holding back. But how did it all end? I opened to my beloved. But my beloved had turned away and had gone. My heart went out to him as he spoke. I searched for him, but I could not find him. I called him, but he did not answer. See, because by the time she now made up her mind to flow, the beloved has gone. That's why I say have long relationships. So that when you see that, Charlie, love, you know, it is one way. You just go your way and find somebody whose love will be a little nearer your love. Yeah. Charlie, you can write it down. I pity you when you marry and you see that your love is like this and the person's love is like this. You send text. You will call. You don't understand what is happening to you. The person has withheld the love. Asterisk and obelisk. Yeah. Asterisk is small and obelisk is big. Big love and small love. Holding back can lead you, can make you lose your love. There are some people who have lost my love for them in a certain sense. Not that I don't love them with the love of the Lord, but the passion and interest and zeal that I had for them and in them, I don't have that passion and zeal. Because I had that love and I stretched out my hand to my beloved, tried to get in. I was getting excuses. By the time they opened, I was gone. I just walked away. It's true. Come giddy giddy, Charlie, let's do this, let's go here, let's do this for them. If you look at somebody like Bishop Saki or Bishop Eddie, the love that I have for the Lord and the love that they had for the Lord is the same kind of love up till today. You see, that even makes us close. Because when people with different loves are interacting, you can't be so close because I love business, you love the Lord. I love ministry, you love something else. Yeah. And when you recognize, Charlie, look for somebody who loves like you love and stay with that person. Yeah. Charlie, look for somebody who loves the way you love and stay with that person. Yeah, that's the advice I'll give you. I remember, you know, when you enter the R block in medical hostel, R block, what is the first room on the left? What's the number? R what? After the porter's lodge on the left. You know, there are three wings. When you enter, there's straight, there's right, there's left. The left is what? R1. It starts from 1. R1 or R2. R1, R2. Yeah. That's where I remember a conversation I had with Bishop Saki over there. Yeah. He was saying, oh, he wants to evangelize, wants to win souls for God. It's all that he wants to do. I recognized a love that I also had. I didn't really know him, but I started to, this is a person that I can stay with. Yeah. Find somebody with similar love. When you marry and you find out that Asuma, she only wanted children, but not you. You see, a lot of people don't know that that's why their hearts are broken. It's only children you wanted, not really you. When you ask her, do you love your husband? You ask, what is love? What do you mean by love? If it is, do you are now defining. Hey. Don't marry somebody who doesn't have same kind of love. Amen. Love is very important. Holding back is painful. And I want to pray for everybody who doesn't understand what I'm saying. Let me pray for you. Father, all those who don't understand what I'm saying, let them experience it so that they will believe it. In Jesus' name. Should I say amen? Okay. Because you are looking at me strange. Now, are you there? You are going home. Do you have breakfast today? Nothing. Okay. We are going all the way. Now, holding back can kill people. Holding back. 2 Samuel chapter 11. In the spring, 2 Samuel chapter 11, verse 1. In the spring, at the time when kings go off to war, David sent Joab out with the king's men. And they destroyed the Ammonites and besieged Rabbah. But David remained in Jerusalem. When it's time to go to war, you are staying in the house. When it's time to go to church, you are in the house. You are in the hostel. Hey! When it's time to be at the camp, look at where you are. One evening, David got up from his bed and walked around on the roof of the palace. And from the roof, he saw a woman bathing. This is ancient pornography. And David sent someone to find out about her. And the man said, "This is Bathsheba, the wife of Uriah the Hittite." Then David sent messengers to get her. And she came to him and he slept with her. She had purified herself from her uncleanness, so she went back home. The woman conceived and sent a word to David saying, "I am pregnant." So David sent this word to Joab, "Send me Uriah the Hittite." And Joab sent him to David. When Uriah came to him, Uriah was one of the soldiers, the husband of this woman. When Uriah came to him, David asked him, "How is Joab?" "Oh, please, he's fine. How are the soldiers and how is the war?" Uriah said, "It is working." Then David said to Uriah, "Go down to your house and wash your feet." And Uriah said, in coded form, "Wash your feet. It has a meaning. Relax. Be happy and forget about the war where you are fighting and do something nice for yourself." Unabody John. So Uriah left the palace and a gift from the king was sent after him. But Uriah did not go home. He slept at the entrance to the palace with all his master's servants and did not go down to his house. When David was told Uriah did not go home, he asked him, "Ah, haven't you just come from a distance? Why didn't you go home? Uriah said to David, the ark and Israel and Judah are staying in tents, and my master Joab and my Lord's men are camped in the open fields. How can I go to my house to eat and drink and lie with my wife? As surely as you live, I would not do such a thing. I should be enjoying blowing time when everybody is struggling. What a soldier. I said, what a soldier. Then David said to him, stay here one more day and tomorrow I'll send you back. So Uriah remained in Jerusalem that day and the next. At David's invitation, he ate and drank with him. And David made him drunk. But in the evening, Uriah went out to sleep on his mat among his master's servants, and he did not go home. There are several possible reasons why, but I don't know. I want to tell you why he didn't go home. In the morning, David wrote a letter to Joab and sent it with Uriah. In it, he wrote, He said, put Uriah in the front line where the fighting is fiercest. Then withdraw. 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 What does the King James say? Retire ye from him. The NIV and the American Bible says withdraw or hold back your forces. Are you listening to me? So while Joab had the city under siege, he put Uriah at a place where he knew the strongest defenders were. And when the men of the city came out against Joab, some of the men in David's army fell. Moreover, Uriah the Hittite died. So Joab sent to David a full account of the battle. And he instructed the messengers, when you have finished giving the king this account of the battle, the king's anger may flare up and he may ask you, why did you get so close to the city to fight? Didn't you know that they will shoot arrows from the wall? Who killed Abimelech, son of Jerubbaal-sheth? Didn't a woman throw an upper millstone on him from the wall so that he died in Thebes? Why did you get so close to the wall? If he asks you this, then say to him, also, Uriah, the servant, Uriah, the Hittite, is dead. The messenger set out, and when he arrived, he told David everything Joab had sent him to say. The messenger said to David, the men overpowered us and came against us in the open, but we drove them back to the entrance of the city gate. And when the archers shot at your servants from the wall, some of the king's men died. Moreover, your servant Uriah the Hittite is dead. David told the messenger, say this to Joab, don't let this upset you. The sword devours one as well as another. Press the attack against the city and destroy it. Say this to encourage Joab. When Uriah's wife heard that her husband was dead, she mourned for him. And after the time was mourning, David had her brought to his house, and she became his wife and bore him a son. But the thing David had done displeased the Lord. It's a sad story. Isn't it? Yeah. Wow. What caused the death of Uriah the Hittite? Apart from David's adultery, withdraw. How did they kill him? They withdrew. Yeah. You see, when the people who are supposed to help you withdraw, you can die because you trusted that you will all be together. Now, I'm trusting that we will all be together going forward. Are you going to hold back? Wow. Are you listening to me? Yeah. Many times I have been out there alone thinking that I was going to make it with people, but they didn't come along. That's why I keep on reaching out more and more people. That's why I came to First Love Church, reaching out for more young people who will say, here I am, send me. Let's all go together. Let's go to the war. Let's go to the mission field. Let's not hold back. Let not some people hold back what God is telling us. Let us all rise up together. Don't hold us. As for me, I'm trying to save myself to be wild, to get this, to get this. While this one is saying, okay, I'm going. Then it becomes like Uriah the Hittite, where when we are fighting at the hottest, Uriah looked back and he said, this has never happened before. That's why I say, don't think it will teach you not to think of a group. Charlie, are we going? We are not going. Are you going? I'm going. You just say to yourself, I am going. Whether somebody comes with me or not, I am going. That's the way your mind must work. If your mind doesn't work that way, you are not going to make it in the ministry. Because you will turn around and say, ah, we were all doctors in the church. Oh, we all said naturally we were going to this. Before I realized, I had gone to Seychelles. When I called back, I realized that nobody has gone. And I'm the only one who has come to this island. Oh, Asomoah, we were 15 and only two of us went. When we went, the others stayed back. Some of you are going to go to Indonesia. Amen. Some of you are going to go to Africa. Amen. Some of you are going to go to islands. Amen. Some of you are going to go to villages in Ghana. Amen. Towns in Ghana. Amen. You are not going to hold back. And say that, you go, I'll come later. Amen. No, 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 no. And you must remember that we are not depending on you. We are all deciding, I am going by myself. I'm going by myself. I'm going by myself. If somebody happens to come, praise the Lord. If nobody comes, then I'm going alone. But at least I'm safer thinking that I'm alone than to think that I'm with five people and then they don't actually come. Is it true or it's not true? So holding back is a very dangerous thing. Amen. What do you think? Wow. How many points do you have? 8 points. Wow. The next one. Holding back, right? Don't hold back so that you can expand. Don't hold back so that you can expand into the ministry God has for you. Amen. Isaiah chapter 54. Sing, O barren woman, you who never bore a child, burst into song, shout for joy, you who were never in labor, because more are the children of the desolate woman than of her who has a husband, says the Lord. Enlarge your tent, the place of your tent. Stretch your tent curtains wide. Do not hold back. Do not hold back. Strengthen your stakes, for you will spread out to the right and to the left. And your descendants will dispossess the nations and settle in their desolate cities. Do not be afraid. Do not hold back. Do not hold back. Lengthen your cords rather. In other words, give yourself more. Amen. Give yourself more. Do not be afraid. You will not suffer shame. Do not fear disgrace. You will not be humiliated. You will forget the shame of your youth and remember no more the reproach of your widowhood. For your maker is your husband. The Almighty is his name. Do not fear disgrace. You will not be humiliated. You will forget the shame of your youth. You will not be disgraced. You will not be disgraced. Wow. I thank the Lord for putting me into the ministry. Amen. I thought I would be disgraced by going to the ministry. I thought I would be ashamed. But God has helped me all these years to be in the ministry. I thought I would be ashamed. I thought that my children wouldn't be able to go to any good school. I thought I would never travel again. But he said, enlarge your tent. Don't hold back. Lengthen your cords. Rather, go out all out. You see, instead of just not holding back, go all the way. Give thyself wholly to God. Give thyself wholly to the Lord. Totally. Yeah. And I tell you, some of you will do greater works. You'll do greater works than have been done up until this time. Stand on your feet, everybody, for a moment. Hey, it's taking you a long time to stand up. All right. You're squeezing him. Lift your hands up for a moment. My God. Help us not to hold back our love. Our love for you. Amen. Help us, Lord. Help us, Lord. Never to hold back anything. Put down your hands. I feel in my heart a lot of people here are holding back. How many feel that you are holding back? How many feel that you are holding back? Raise your hand. God wants to deliver you from holding back. You are holding back. It's like you are giving, but let me keep something. Let me keep myself. Let me hold something so that I don't lose everything. Lift your hand and say, Lord, save me from the evil spirit of holding back. Help me to keep myself holy to you, holy to you, holy to you, my God, my God, my God, my God. Bandon jombon danza manakat, kerembele mozimbendelebe, pariondolo monozinketebere, perendelebe jimudakas bandelere, parondolondebe sendebreke, tebrenale kabondo shenebre, mandelebrege bolozombre dekesh, telembele manabrekele. Colombre que ta balada de belete badal badasaba chelebe katla morimes mantel bigles regles shum lekre bad pelentle que pes mentre bekejedes shembe zmata le mono sin que te lebre que te sento lombo lo que te de belegedes per endili bo caple cremeglis per endili bancan to la mica de spegegede per endombolo e tre baganagede Fende bele bolo belende de breda, pele doblo de beredolo, balembro alebre quereldolo, beredilo baradala beledulu beredili mandeleme, polondoli bendelemene, mendilimon engembendolo mora, herembolo di bereli bandeli borke, kerebulege galablagede lombrogadele mechimbelegodoso, ferrebeline bendelemo cande belendo bolo di vishendelere. Mentaleman, Mentolomon, Saint Belide, Verigulet, Valedulim, San Delemon, Tilibendili, Copolodi Kemene, Telemen, Mon, Setele, Abre, Andel, Mendolo, Le, 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 Parembele de Bolo Libendile Parembe de Bredele Mushindele Maka Kerembele Munusumbele di Berelibene di Bolonili Herembele Boli di Biki Palanda Maso Molo di Berekemele Le Frebele du Shibele Rimende Kebalanda Rivene Lendo, 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 Lando, 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 Mando, Mendele, Pereda, Melede, Pajele, Talama, Parede, Maseke, Talasa, Machedi, Satoble, Tebere, Caribas, Leleke, Kaleke, Dekele, Kabala, Tebere, Perende, Tembese, Chinjili, Nankaria, Rocoboloso, Tecribelese, Tiprivalide, Chimedalese, Mandelekeba, Tapara, Tapara, Mandeleba, Batabere Vidube, Perevido Bereve, Perevido Bereve, Perevido Berede, 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 Da parami de prefele divide 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 divide. Replebe di vishi beka paramunu semena ke parina mele vise ne bana ne bale prede ne ke prenele. Pere do bere bride. Sondeli me ke prive. Tele di mo bele vini shi bene na mani bole di me. Lembele ne mo ke parele li vini zene bele de. Tele de vena di lo mo si dele le me ke be. Ero mo di li vini bere di vini shi di vini di vini do li di vini di vini di vini di. My God. My God, my God, my God, my God, my God. Zambolo mo kapalande le di vini. Hello rombo dali de 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 My God, my God, damo shumba kama zambele. Vendolo bola le 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 le. Chendo rama mandele le 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 le. Velo rumuna le le le. Mandele rumu shani makibana le 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 le. Olo rumuna le 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 le. Vendolo Ramadale, 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 Ramadale day, Ramadale day, Ramadale day. Allah the Lord, 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 the Lord God, my God, my God. Hallelujah. Father, thank you for the gift of your word, your spirit. Lord, we give ourselves wholly to you. Let your perfect will be done in our lives. take away from us, Lord, the spirit of holding back, that we may not lose everything, that we may not lose the opportunity we have, the privilege we have, the blessing we have, the place we have, because we held back what we should not have held back. Save us, oh God. We thank you for your great power. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated.
J-E to the S-U-S. Tell me nobody's ever gonna mess with S. Chicken air, headed straight to the top. Boy, you be near me, make this a mana like a flip flop. Hip hop is dead, killed him on the highway. I'm gonna crash the rest. Hooray, front page, news in your radio.
Yeah, come closer. Come closer. Come closer. Come closer. You know, it has been a wonderful 7 day and 7 night fasting and prayers. Yeah. You know, see, God is going to use us marvelously.
Yes.
Yeah, He's going to use us wonderfully.
Yes.
Makohia. Sondiandele. For thou sayest the Lord.
Yes.
Serve the Lord with all your hearts.
Yes.
With all your soul. And with all your mind.
Yeah.
See, we have to enter into the ministry fully. Yeah, you see, that is the word for us.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, so I'll meet you at the foot of the mountain. Yeah, I'll meet you at the foot of the mountain. All right.
Pastor, this message is powerful. I'm giving myself fully to the ministry.
Wow, praise Jesus.
I have to go to the villages and be a missionary.
Yeah.
I want to be a pastor of thousands.
It's too powerful.
Oh, yes. Oh, thank you for the word.
Yeah.
It's powerful. Fully.
Wow.
My son, Tosi, my cat, Talibidu.
I feel mocked. Some psychedelic.
John mocked the pastor and God as well by not coming for the missions.
Charlie, what are we?
The message is wild.
It's very wild. You have to give yourself holy.
Are you going to give yourself?
Oh, yes. I mean, what else do you want me to do?
So you will give yourself?
Yes, you have to go on missions. You have to go on missions and preach the word of God.
You take your whole self and give.
Fully.
Me, I'm thinking about it, but, you know, I'm going to school now. So after school, get a job. But you are giving yourself fully.
You want to work?
Yes.
School. Have you heard what Pastor said? Give yourself wholly.
I know it is holy. I will give myself. You don't understand. If I'm done with school, then I'll think about it. But right now, I have an assignment to do. I'm going to the library. You'll be there. Think of yourself.
Look, you have to think about it too.
So, you want to be a pastor? I mean, I don't get it. You are one of the useless people I've been assigned to. Wait, okay. So, if you become a pastor, let me see. No, you have to be a shepherd. If you are fortunate, they will make you an elder. Then you can become a pastor. And then what? Wait, nothing else. You may end up dying with some 50 members in your church who may not even come for your funeral service. But if you listen to this logical, very sensible suggestion I'm going to give you, see, you can enter into politics. SRC president, then you can assemblyman. Before you realize, you are the president of the country. Think of the fame, the money, everything. And look, besides, you can even be like Nelson Mandela. When you die, a lot of people will come to your funeral, except that you won't get a fake interpreter at your funeral. Think about it.
No. I rebuke every voice of the devil in the name of Jesus. No, I can't.
Get away. I am not the devil. I'm your mind. Look, You see, okay, fine. You can combine the two. Politician, Christian. Not a Christian politician, a politician Christian. Eh? Look, can you imagine the convoy? Don't die without a car or anything. You can easily die as a pastor without a car. This thing that you are doing. Look, I'm your mind. If you suffer, I suffer. So please, do what I'm telling you.
I mean, I'm a very good student in political science. I mean, why should I waste that? I can combine the two. I can pursue being an SLC president.
Good.
Then I can climb up. I can climb up. Up. I want to become president.
Yeah.
President.
Yeah.
Wow. I'll pursue this.
Exactly.
I'll go into politics.
Mr. President.
Pastor,
yeah.
Pastor, this thing is not easy.
Giving yourself wholly
is not easy at all.
My spirit loves God. If you see my heart, it wants to win thousands of souls. But the flesh, the mind, yeah. If it comes to the sexicality aspect,
you understand, Pastor? You understand that? Then that area, especially when it has to do with fair ladies.
Fair ladies. Pastor. See, let me tell you something.
You have to give the Lord with you have to come in with all your heart. All your desires has to be for the ministry. Your soul. All the feelings and your mind. You see, the mind would want to be logical in a way, but you have to tell it,
tell your mind that, mind, come, shut up and come with me. Honorable Inshaw. Yeah, that is what you have to do.
Pastor.
Oh, yeah.
Good afternoon, Pastor.
Oh, good afternoon. How are you doing?
Fine, thank you.
That's good.
Oh, Harry. Hello, Harry. Good afternoon. Yes. Pastor.
Yeah.
Ella, come for him. Pastor, this is my shepherd.
Shepherd?
Yes.
Wow.
She is a shepherd, yeah. Not my shepherd.
I've noticed
she's
her,
my church.
I've noticed her in the church very powerfully.
Yes, very powerful. Pastor, I'm doing well. I'm doing very well.
Wow.
Yes, I told her, I said, I'll give myself holy. Wow. You see?
That's it.
Yes.
That's it.
Yes. Pastor, you know what? I want to discuss something with you for a few minutes.
With me?
Yes.
Oh, why not?
You see, Pastor.
Yeah.
Yesterday night, I had a dream.
A dream?
Yes.
A vision.
A vision.
Wow.
I was standing on top of a mountain.
A mountain?
Yes. And when I looked to my left and my right, the north, I saw people suffering.
People suffering?
People suffering, Pastor.
Wow.
And I saw myself saying, let my people go. Let my people go. Chobot. Chobot.
Wow. Yes. Praise
Pastor.
Jesus.
You know, and when I woke up, when I had my morning devotion, I mean, I was surprised to see that I was reading about how Moses delivered the Israelites from Egypt.
It's a message from God.
Yes. I think I have been called, Pastor. It's a calling. I've been called to save the people of Ghana from this miserable state of the things they are going through. The
people of Ghana. What do you mean by people of Ghana?
Pastor, you see, I feel like God is trying to tell me that the people of Ghana are suffering. Look at the light off. Look at the taps are not flowing. Yes. Yes. I think that's my calling.
No, what are you saying? No, but I was praying at Mount Nafajat when you called me. You said that you felt the call of God on your life. So we should come and have 7-day fasting and prayers. And what has entered into you?
Pastor, you don't understand. See, I'll keep myself holy, but I have to do this calling. If God calls you, won't you do it? Yes.
Come, listen to me.
Do you know you're a very beautiful girl?
I heard that many times.
Hey, you've heard it many times. But have you heard it from me?
Yeah.
And you are a very fair lady.
I can't see. Why?
I know you can see. I'm telling you, you are fair. I know you can see. Did you fall from the moon?
The sky.
Aha! I knew it. You cannot come out from the earth like that. You might. You have to fall. I like you very much.
I'm not interested. You are too raw, natural.
Oh. I'm coming the way I am. You see, I'm too natural.
I'm not interested. Thank you.
Oh, you want me to come like a pop star? Just as I said, pastor is here. You approve it. You go to my room. You know my house. You understand what I'm saying? Eh? You understand? Just
Thank
accept.
You very much. I'm not.
Oh.
I'm not interested.
So, pastor, you see, I have to do the call. I have to be a politician.
I want you to pray about this, but I don't feel
you have a gift. You have a wonderful gift of attracting people to you. This message of God is for you to go out and to invite people, thousands, millions. That is what it means. Please pray about it. We'll talk later. Okay, let's go and see the others. Yes. So, but oh, so Ella, let's go. Let's go. So, pastor,
bless.
I'll pray about it,
sure, yeah,
but I have to do the call.
Elder Eric.
Pastor.
What, do you see something that you like?
Pastor, I'm overseeing.
Yeah, since you enter into the ministry, you have to marry early. But then you can't approach your sister like this.
I was proposing to her.
Oh, no. There must be training. Follow me. I will teach you the art of getting a beloved. All right?
Yeah. Pastor, getting beloved too, you need training.
Let's go.
Oh. This girl, she must accept me.
But you, what's this foolish thought about going for missions? Young man like you want to go for missions. Listen, this pastor that he's talking to, he's a man of knowledge with no experience. Have you seen him going for missions?
No, I've not seen pastor going for missions.
It's a good thing to go for missions. You have to go. It's a call on your life. You have to do it, okay?
And this thought about getting married, look at you, 23. You want to get married, you want to settle down. Are you stupid? You're too raw. The girl won't like you. Within 7 days, you'll be done with her. She's fair. Listen, you're a multi-directional human being. You're supposed to service this one, service this, and service the rest. We've seen this before. Brother, organize yourself.
You really need to give yourself wholly to marriage. It's good for you to marry than to bear. Marry.
Listen, I know you've missed these porn stars. Catherine Rose, Alexis Brown. Listen, find your iPad. Find your iPad now. Yes. History. Remember last week you were trying to look for it? Yes. Good.
No, that is bad. Stop it. Abstain from all appearances of evil.
Oh!
Stop.
This girl... That is why she won the award.
No. Stop. Stop. Abstain from all appearances of evil.
This girl is wild.
Where is she learning? This is a good time to do hey. Some microscopic studies.
I will not watch pornography. I won't watch you.
Yes. Hey, take your Bible. Take your Bible, do a microscopic Bible study. Now, yes, go to that scripture. Romans 1 verse 9. It's a good scripture, yeah.
You've already had your quiet time.
Wow, good.
Listen, good. This won't work.
Man, de shatari bro, satayaba, kandiburu. Man, do satayaba, ah! You flesh, I mute your voice. I rebuke you in the mighty name of Jesus. You won't speak again. Don't speak to me again.
Knock, knock.
Don't speak.
Knock, knock.
Oh.
Good afternoon. Please, I'm looking for Elder Ellie.
Elder Ellie. Elder Ellie is not around.
Okay, I'm taking my leave.
Oh, you. Why?
I have to go.
You are looking very nice today.
Oh, thank you.
You have nice slippers on.
Thank you. I didn't notice.
Oh, you don't need to notice out here.
Look.
You have nice hair. You are looking very beautiful. Just I never knew you could smile.
Thank you.
You have a lovely smile.
Yes.
Look. Be careful. Be careful.
She has a nice smile. I know you want to kiss her. Kiss her.
Stop. Stop.
Kiss her.
Stop. Stop. Stop.
I know what Thessalonians 5:22. Be reminded of that scripture. Be careful.
I said kiss her.
I shut up!
What's wrong with you? Is everything okay?
Oh, that is how the room behaves.
Okay.
So you need to tell the room what to do.
Okay.
The room behaves that way.
Okay.
Oh, don't mind the room. We deal with it every time. So let's go. Let me take you to a nice place. We'll talk more.
I'm in.
Yes, let's go. You take her to the room and you see what will happen.
Flesh, shut up and follow me. You belong to me, I don't belong to you. You understand?
Is everything
shut
okay?
Oh, it's a room. Let's go.
Got married after 2 years of beloved dozen. And having listened carefully and given themselves entirely to the and following the word of God, they are now missions in Devo in Ivory Coast, winning 1,000 souls for the Lord. 20 years later.
How you going to?
Oh yeah, hello. You can come into my office.
Pastor. Good afternoon, Pastor.
Oh, good afternoon.
It's good to see you again.
Please, how may I help you?
Oh, Pastor, it's Elder Ellie. Remember those
Elder
days?
Elder Ellie.
Commonwealth Hall Church.
Commonwealth, yes.
Wow.
Yes. I was doing very well, remember? I brought that... Ella, I was doing very
well. I remember Ella very well.
Yes.
Hey, you were doing very well.
Yes, Pastor. It is
you were,
me. I'm the
you
one.
Doing very well.
Yes.
But I mean, it's a surprise. After 20 years, what are you doing in my office?
Pastor, the past 20 years have amounted to nothing. I mean, I had 100 foot soldiers in all the 230 constituencies. And I failed the elections, Pastor.
You failed.
The polling agents didn't even vote for me.
Wow.
Nobody voted. Pastor, I want to come back. I want to go on missions.
You want to go on missions?
Yes. I want to go.
But it's too late. You're too weak. You can't.
No, Pastor. Look, I'm still energetic.
See, you're energetic, but I'm now pastoring that church. Kadosh Cathedral. The
Kadosh.
3x3 kilometer church.
Yes, yes.
You see,
yes.
The east side, we need some ashes, so I think you should come and help in. I want you to show the ashes where to go, yes.
But Pastor, look, I can go on missions.
Yeah, your strength will be used in passing ashram bowls, yes. It's okay. Oh, please come in.
Oh, Pastor.
Wow.
Good afternoon, Pastor.
Oh, good afternoon. How are you doing?
I'm fine, Pastor.
Lady Pastor Ella.
Yes. Wow.
Reverend Eric.
Yes, Pastor.
How is Devo?
Pastor, we Pastor. Give God the glory.
Pastor, is that not Eric?
Oh, yes, Eric. Remember? Eric. Elder Eli.
Eric, my roommate.
No, Reverend Eric.
Reverend Eric.
Yes.
Elder Eli.
Yes.
Oh. Elder Eli.
Yes, me. Eric, where have you been? You're not a reverend.
He's not a reverend. And you remember your sheep?
My sheep. My sheep.
Ella.
Ella.
No. Lady Pastor Ella.
The one I saved. Wait, the prostitute.
No.
Lady Pastor Ella. Remember her. You see, Reverend Eric is now pastoring a church of 5,000 people in Tivo, and he's doing wonderful.
Wow. Yes. Pastor, I want to join them.
Relax.
We can see.
It's too late. With your muscle right now, I think you would be an usher in my church. Yes, I want you to start from there. All right?
1 Timothy 4, verse 15. Be diligent in all these matters. Give yourself wholly to them, so that everybody may see your progress. Amen and thank you.
Giddy up now, live it in heaven, I hope to get back well. Till then, we are on the Red Cross, saving souls like it took an oath. Drop so many lines, I'm so DC's here, I'll set them, take them all, leave it. All of my God, yeah, his refusion, never going cycle, so I tell him, Kalu. Mau, 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 mau.
What do you do, Christians?
Mau, 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 mau.
You don't need to be told. You don't really want to miss church. You don't really want to miss church. You don't really want to miss church. You don't really want to miss church.
Mau.
No, say you no know the feel.
I'm a winner, I'm a winner, I'm a winner.
Put your one hand up. If you know, say you cannot be stopped.
I'm a winner.
Doesn't matter what the situation. Go say your potential.
I'm a winner.
Make this bold confession. In the face of a hand.
I'm a winner.
God is there, my side, oh. Will never leave, oh. I'm an overcomer. I don't know the defeat, oh. Everything I do, every word I say, everything I touch, I just don't believe, oh. Everywhere I go, rain or shine, I will be on top.
I'm a winner.
I'm winning in the morning, winning in the afternoon or night.
I'm a winner.
My cup overflows with power in the name of Jesus.
I'm a winner.
God is there, my side, oh. He will never leave, oh. Champion.